No less than President Marcos Jr. is cautious about revoking the franchise. Let's start off with this. Can the government actually revoke a franchise that was given to the NGCP in 2008 and is not expiring soon?
The franchise, kasi binigayan ng it's the Congress that gave it to them, so Congress can take it back anytime or revise it. I have to be clear lang, Karen. The DOE is not saying irrevoke yan. We just need to review it if our audit results that there are some lapses from NGCP.
Mm-mm. But Undersecretary, under what grounds, so we have an idea, can an NGCP franchise be revoked?
Actually, it's the plenary power of Congress. They can make, it's a law, a franchise. So they can repeal a law anytime or revise a law or amend a law. So hindi naman kailangan ng, technically wala namang kailangan na reason as far as I know, no, na pwede mong palitan yung batas. Basta ano yan, that's the prerogative of Congress. But anyhow, I think just to be fair with NGCP and any other franchise holder, kailangan i-investigate kung merong lapses on the responsibilities na binigay. For example, on NGCP, we want to audit if they have performed all the projects that they committed. Ang three major projects natin in NGCP is Hermosa San Jose, which will connect Bataan to Metro Manila. And then pag-connect ng Visayas and Mindanao, which is going through Cebu, and then also the Panay and Negros connection. Those, for example, we have to assess kasi na-delay na siya eh. Some about, actually, around 4 years na yung iba eh. So there are reasons, but we want to have a very constructive assessment of their performance.
So number one is accountability on performance. And you described actually the franchise given to NGCP itself. You said it was overly generous. Can you talk about that? Why is it overly generous?
It's generous in a sense na ang taxes nito is 3% in lieu of everything. So hindi na magbabayad yan ng corporate income tax, kahit mga real estate tax, lahat sa local sales tax, everything. VAT, wala rin sila. It's only 3% that they pay because that's what the franchise says. So other franchise, iba yan eh. May mga ibang babayad sila sa local, babawasan yung corporate income tax, but this is different. And in terms of accountability, practically the supervisory power of Transco, kasi in Transco nagbigay ng concession, is really lacking. Kasi in fact now, I'm not sure kung up to what extent can Transco enter or even review their operations.
Oo. Pero ang tanong dito po, no, looking back, you were once a congresswoman. Why do you believe that these were the conditions of the taxes given to NGCP?
I think also kasi we were trying to build as one grid lang. Kasi maganda kasi if there's only one grid, you can synchronize and harmonize all the powers that are being generated. So if there's one operator and one grid, so we can maximize the utility as long as the building of the infrastructure of the grid and the generation are in sync. But now, since there are delays in the grid construction, medyo nagkaka-problema tayo. Anyway, so why was it like that? I think that is one incentive that we gave it to them. No? It was purchased, I think, around $4 billion. That's a huge investment. And someone was willing to, a private entity, to undertake the huge responsibility. So part na rin yan ng incentive sa kanila. But also now, if you look at the subsequent franchises that were given by Congress, I don't think I've seen anything like that, na 3% siya. So it's time to review, no?
Yeah.
Not cancel naman kung wala namang reason. Just to review and strengthen the supervisory or even the authority of government. Kasi medyo hindi makakulang yung powers or teeth of government with that franchise.
Okay, so Undersecretary, you've brought in two things, performance and the conditions surrounding the tax incentives Correct. Given to the franchise. I'm curious, is it legal to change it midstream, given they have a solid contract under the franchise agreement?
The powers of the institution that gave the franchise, the plenary powers, is that what is subscribed in the Constitution. Congress can enact a law. Basta they get enough votes, they go through the process. It depends on Congress. So hindi po illegal yan. That's totally within the power, the plenary powers of Congress.
Okay. Undersecretary Senator J.B. Ejercito and other senators have brought up the security issue with China actually owning 40% of the NGCP. But then Filipinos have come out and said, we run everything. There is no security threat. Ang tanong dito, no, is this a factor in your asking Congress to review?
As of now, as of the last hearing, I didn't consider that as a factor because we don't have any findings yet, Karen. We need to make investigations. It's not fair to say, like, because this is a foreign country or the 40% investment are Chinese and then there's a security question. What if it's Americans or any other country?
No, or any country.
We need to make the proper audit and then and be very constructive and para ma-assess. As of now, as far as we are, DOE can see, it's the performance that we are concerned of. As to the security, those are still unconfirmed for us, so we need to make the assessment and then we can tell the public kung ano yung assessment ng DOE.
But what does the executive recommend? I mean, clearly you, Secretary Lutilia, you want to go to a specific direction. Is it wiser today to actually have a certain percentage of NGCP owned by the government? Because it was privatized fully for a reason.
It's a structure that we have seen also in other countries. In fact, in Spain, for example, the government has a stake, I think, around 20%. And the president appoints the CEO. Mm-hmm. There's accountability also on that part. And those are things that we are trying to evaluate. Kasi it's not only about security in terms of energy, but also national security. That's why the topic has been brought up. So it's the grid. Once the grid is down, then the whole country is blacked out. And that's very expensive for us and very dangerous. So I understand the concerns. Pero we need to make the investigation very constructive. Para wala naman na we are very judgmental in that sense. Kailangan talaga logical yung pag-assess natin.
Pero Undersecretary, ang hypothetical situation, which may not be too hypothetical in the near future. Secretary Lutilia at one point said it was impossible for the government to take over Malampaya because of financial limitations. When it comes to NGCP, is it also a financial limitation? Or just honestly, kaya bilhin ng gobyerno a certain stake?
I think the government can have a stake there. Also, even just appointment of for control, no, of the board or any officers there they may have, no. So kaya naman ng gobyerno, I would believe. And if the government really wants to, then we can take out a loan or sell some assets. But I think, or we can get it in our budget, no. Pero kaya ng gobyerno naman, I think.
Mm-mm. Oh, because I think you've said or. The DOE has said that, is this correct? 80% of the country's electricity problems is actually linked to the NGCP's issues.
Well, it was Congressman Dagoog that emphasized that. I would not say exactly 80%, but I think the point was majority of our problems come from the grid. Because Visayas is not connected to Mindanao, and Mindanao has excess power. We cannot send the excess power to Luzon and Visayas. That's, for example, Panay, Iloilo had a blackout. It was because of instability of the grid. Kasi it's not enough to cater for the power plants in Negros, the solar farms, and the biomass fuel that they have there. So nagiging unstable siya. And it's because the grid is unstable. So also Bataan, we have so many power plants there. Pwede na siyang iba to sa Manila, but we have constraints in the grid. So there are the projects are so are quite delayed, Karen. Sayang, I will tell you lang ha. For example, in Luzon, we have Hermosa San Jose. It's supposed to be finished. The original target is June 2019. Ngayon, hindi pa siya completely ready, and it's been moved 5 times already. The Cebu Negros Panay was supposed to be finished in December 2020, and the new target is August 2023. There are so many plans, there are so many generation plans also that are depending on this, and they've been waiting for 5 years. So medyo it's getting worse and worse, no?
Oo. Ang tanong ko lang, Undersecretary, does the EPIRA law, is a change in the EPIRA law a factor to actually hold NGCP accountable for all these delays?
We can put it in the EPIRA, but I do not think it's enough because the franchise is a franchise. That's why when the question was raised, that is this the same question that the congressman asked. Now, is it enough to correct this problem? And that's why we responded, if you really want to correct the whole structure, then you need to change EPIRA and review the franchise of NGCP. Para lang ma-restructure lang siya so that we can address and not have the same problems over and over again.
Okay. Is it possible for another entity to actually build all the transmission lines that have been delayed? Is that legal?
That's the what EPIRA says, there should be only one. And the essence of the grid, the point of the grid is to have one lang naman. That's how many countries do it, because it's more efficient and more less expensive for everyone if we only have one grid. Now, if somebody takes over, we don't know, Karen, na? We don't know how that will proceed. Right now, we are focusing on correcting what we can correct with the current structure. If we can correct the structure through NGCP, and it probably will work, then we can stick with that. But if Congress believes or na kailangan i-cancel, then that's the prerogative of Congress. But the question is, who will take over, and if the entity that will take over can do a better job? So those are questions also. So we need to go slowly on this and not be emotional in our decision and what to do with the franchise of NGCP.
But then on a side note, what can government do to actually fast track the 3 transmission lines that would make a difference in our electricity rates?
We are continuously working with NGCP, ERC, the same thing. This is not just NGCP problem. This is a problem also of DOE because we have to work with them. And that this administration has been very closely working with them. Wala nang away. So at one point, for example, the ERC impose a penalty for some lapses of NGCP, but it's only 50 million per. So that's why in EPIRA we are proposing to increase the penalties as well. So we are working together with NGCP, with Transco, ERC, just to hasten this. We visit the sites, we help them with the, we have been contacting the ILG and also the LGUs to help with the fast tracking of the permits of the towers. We have contacted the courts if ever kung yung mga right of way nila, and those are cleared already. They have NGCP has said na that cleared na yung wala na silang problem with permits and right of way. So it's now construction part, and they are really working hard to catch up para matapos na siya by the time that August comes.
Okay, so my last question is a short-term solution that's going to be August. What changes would you want to see in NGCP? Is it an accountability penalty issue, or you'd like to see a change in management?
No, I think more on the accountability and the penalties, kasi para may leverage din yung government. And I would like to see a more closer work environment between government and NGCP, kasi ngayon medyo hindi ganun ka effective yung system. Now government can have a say in the decision making, whether how much dividends to give out or how much what projects we should do. The government should be really involved in that, and that's what I would like to see, sana.
So is this an issue for the DOE, that despite issues, I mean problems, that NGCP is paying, dividends have been given out to their management? Big dividends. Is this one of the issues?
That's part of the audit that we want to see. We don't want NGCP charges by saying we will start this project. Once that is approved by ERC, that's already in your bill, Karen. That's a charge na yan. So if they don't start, you still pay. And you keep paying for it kahit hindi nag-uumpisa yung project, because so it's unfair to the consumer. So ang objective talaga is that it's for us to assess what do you do with the collections that you do. We need to audit that. Is the dividend payout a deterrent in the projects that we are doing? Then that's a major problem we have. We want to do the proper audit, or maybe they have enough cash naman to give to their shareholders. So ang audit talagang hinihintay namin, so that we don't act so irrationally, and we are constructive in our assessment. Kailangan talaga malaman kung anong nangyayari sa financials, and that is totally the right of every Filipino to check that.
And I absolutely agree, because the nature of their business is they are a monopoly.
Correct.
There is no choice. So are we trying to say, ma'am, that this would be the first audit in how many years?
Well, this is in recent history, not only an audit on financial, but also in performance. Because the issue has a life of its own. It's grown bigger and bigger. We are setting the parameters and all the guidelines on the audit para matapos na siya. Because of all the calls on questioning about security and about their franchise. Just to be fair naman and very logical, we want the audit to be very thorough this time.
All right, on that note, Energy Undersecretary Sharon Garin, thank you for joining me
today.
I know you have a meeting, but thank you for joining me.
Thank you.